Good evening. This is Eugene Rountree. High voltage news coming at you. Wednesday night, March 19th, 2014. We're going to start off this triple rock block by Rammstein. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Lots happening in the news today, so I bring you high voltage news. Rand Paul says that he wants to know who's running this government. I agree. I'm glad that somebody in Congress is pointing out that Congress needs to look around and see whether or not they really are running Congress, because quite honestly, with the things that are happening in our backwards day, opposite day government, you will see very clearly that stuff does not make sense. Can't pay for food in the home front, continually trying to get into wars with our chicken hawk John McCain, 77-year-old warmonger. You know what, John McCain? You want to go fight somebody? Step into a UFC ring, okay? Get in there, take your bum shoulder, and go fight someone. You don't speak for all of us Americans that are out here working every single day, minding our own business, paying our tax dollars to who knows what just to be spied on, and go into another stupid war alongside of your Al-Qaeda, CIA-funded mercenaries. We're tired of it. I don't like looking at my brothers in arms and seeing them go over there to fight stupid little chicken hawk wars. It's absurd. And then you want to take our guns away here back home. Get a clue, John McCain. Hospice is waiting for you and the bed is drawn. Your bathwater is warm and ready. Get out of Congress. Stop representing yourself. Stop representing the people lining your pockets with silver and go get a life. Same goes for you, Harry Reid. Enough is enough. All of you guys look like the walking dead in a three-piece suit. I don't care if you put Botox on your face, John Kerry. The gig is up. You don't speak for any of us. You married into money. You've never even bottled a bottle of ketchup in your life. But your last name is Hines, along with six more zeros behind your bank account. And now you guys want to sign us up for this Obamacare? Enough is enough. We got people not able to wear American flags to school in California on Cinco de Mayo because it's going to upset the Mexicans. Are you kidding me? You can't speak English in America now? You can't have a nationalistic flag? Is nationalism and country, nation, statehood passé 20th century and prior barbaric way of life? Is that what it is? Because now we're in this global economy, so everybody's got to be a third world citizen, except the banksters, the corporateers, the middleman bureaucrats who are nothing but a middle manager. Is that the new life? Is that the utopia for you guys? It's horrible. It's absurd. So Rand Paul's absolutely right in wondering who the hell is governing us. Because it sure isn't we the people electing people from the people. It's your two little puppets you give us every 4 years with a token vote, and then you pass anything you want. We're old enough, we're smart enough, all of us have seen it, and we grew up in a free country thinking that we are tolerant and free. We're sick of the race baiting, we're sick of the homosexual, heterosexual fighting. And you guys may put it up on your state-run media, but I don't see it in action every day when I do transactions in the business world. Everybody seems to be getting along just fine, like civilized, grown-up adults. We're not a bunch of idiots. Just because we watch sports in our time when we're not working 60 hours a week doesn't mean jack. Plenty of us are paying attention to the bills that you write, the ones that you don't even read. Nancy Pelosi says you got to pass a bill to know what's in the bill. Are you kidding me? Well, let me write some bills for you. I've got some pretty good bills that aren't going to bode so well for the bureaucrats. You want me to pass some of those so you can find out what my ideas are? Are you ready for that? Nancy Pelosi, your jig is up too. We don't need 100-year-old senators, 100-year-old congressmen. Come on. There's poli-sci majors graduating with degrees every year. There's plenty of people that can do some work. Is it because you guys don't know too many secrets? Is it because you guys have too much blood on your hands? So now it's like this internal clique? Well, democide's a word not taught in schools, but it should be taught from preschool on. Because what age are you going to say, well, you passed the abortion line, you were allowed to live, well, now we got to send you into another war. At what age do you say that this child is just a human resource, throw them to the side? Because that's all we're seeing with your policies. It's horrible. You want to take the fluoride out of the water yesterday? You want to start doing something about Fukushima? How's your radiation? You want to stop buying hollow point bullets through government agencies called the USPS and the DHS? Homeland Security? Look, you guys have started enough wars in enough countries, put in too many puppet dictators just to piss off the whole world against us, just so you can crash the system of the free nation state that is America, that wants life, liberty, land, prosperity, and peace. Even though we might have a little teeth with the Second Amendment, you guys want to turn all that up on its head just so you can say it failed and just so you can have a global dictatorship with your little clique. What happens after the White House and Congress? What position do you move to next after you serve your little term? Because all of you guys change your hats, go to Secretary of State, go to Ambassador, go to Vice President. Now you're in this job, now you're in that job, now you represent the UN. At what point do you shift it into, like, global kingship? Because that's all we see with your shape-shifting. Have I said enough yet? Our little token vote every 4 years doesn't mean jack squat. When you debase the currency, when you print it until it's so common that it doesn't even matter, even though you give the currency to the corporations just to put it into Wall Street, and it doesn't even help the little guy, just so you can get another profit when that bubble bursts, and you yank it and put it into something else. While all of us just go to work every day for an hourly rate, which is exactly what you want in the Communist Manifesto, so that we can be a day laborer, work from sun up to sun down, watch the moon go down, as beautiful as it is right now, it's nice and orange, big and round, and I have to say to myself, what on earth did I do to be born in this day and age where everything's freaking backwards day policies from the government, and you look at them, and they're comical. They're like the WWF fighters when they're being interviewed and when they're wrestling. When you guys go to work, you guys are a joke. When you guys come out of work and you talk about it on state-run media, you're still a joke. The things that Joe Biden says are laughable, and we know it's on purpose. It's a distraction because you guys are horrible. Have I said enough yet? You guys aren't cool, and you go around touting your little vacations where you're seen swimming in the ocean or playing another round of golf. Well, good for you. Any of us can pick up a golf club and play some golf, but not if we're enslaved. How about that? So what are we going to do about it? We're going to keep allowing the rigged elections or the broken Chad on the ticket to just get our 49 to 51% right under the wire winner? We're going to do that every 4 years? You guys are a big joke. You talk about how, oh, Russia invaded Crimea. Oh, you can't do this sovereign nation stuff. Well, they voted to join Russia. Yeah, 95% Russian anyways. What are you guys doing in every single country in the Middle East? How's this Arab Spring? When does the summer come? When does the Arab summer come? Where they're all out enjoying the nice sunny day. I can keep going. You guys give us plenty of fodder every single day. Now NASA is in the business of predicting the economic doomsday scenarios. Great. I liked it when NASA used to print books about the stars, space, and the sun, and comets, and everything else. That was worth living for. And now they're predicting economic collapse. Well, I've got an economic system. You want to bring about socialism with your trendy help everybody else out policy? Okay. Empty your bank account and give it to everybody. Be a leader with it and do it. Stop trying to suck the life out of everybody like a giant leech. That's when I might believe that socialism has a chance. But right now, all you've done is given golden parachutes, corporate CEOs paving the way for them to be the arm of the government, an arm of the globalist, an arm of the bankster. You just bailed out all the banks. Well, that didn't help anybody. Now you got a lot of homeless people and a bunch of people that can't even get a job or a loan or a car. Great job. You guys are true leaders. Oh, but you saved the day, didn't you? No, let the banks crash. Big freaking deal. So there's a brick building that's empty down the street. There's plenty of other banks. Oh, but that CEO, he's got a family. Oh, really? He couldn't make it on his prior 10 years of salary? He didn't save enough? Come on. You don't go in debt and take more money out in debt, and that doesn't really put you in debt. We can shut off the national debt clock. These are extraordinary measures. Come on, you guys are like 10-year-olds playing Monopoly. And you just open another Monopoly box and it's legal. Big deal. Seriously, I can't say it enough. You talking heads, you pundits that are...